second unit, that is image in transforms. So today we are supposed to discuss about the introduction of second unit, that is image transform. So saying about this second unit, image transforms, here we are supposed to see different types of transforms. We are supposed to see different types of transform, that is discrete Fourier transform, discrete Fourier cosine transform, Walls transform, Hadamard transform, Hotelling transform. So these are some of the transforms we were using in images. So for image processing, we are doing these transforms. So when saying about this transform, we will be classifying this transform into three. One is 2D orthogonal transforms, unitary transforms, and then fast algorithm transforms. So like this, the types of transforms can be classified into three. So all these things we were discussing in this second unit. So currently, as an introduction about this second unit, you can see what is mean by this image transform. An image transform can be applied to an image to convert it from one domain to another. So the use of image transform is to convert from one domain to another, otherwise to move from one domain to another domain. What is the same thing we are doing here? Normally the image will be represented in one form. For the computational purpose, we need to convert to another form of representation. So such scenario, we will be moving from one domain to another. This is done with the help of image transform. Example, here we have given a block diagram, that is a normal image f of x comma y, which will be in the spatial domain. This is the default domain. So for the purpose of carrying out some operations in the image, we are converting this spatial domain image into frequency domain with the help of forward transformation. So after the image is converted to forward transformation, various analyses can be carried out. Fast computation can be carried out. So considering these, all these things, we are carrying out the necessary operation what are to be carried out in the image. Then again we will come back. Using inverse transformation, and we will retrieve the image back. That is g of x comma y as correspond to spatial domain. So this is the scenario of image transformation. Example, here we are given one example, that is the input image is given to a transmitter where forward transformation is carried out, then quantization is done, after that encoding is performed. Then that compressed image is transmitted, and on the other end, receiver end, it is received. Again it is the inverse of encoded, that is decoding is done. Then here inverse transformation is carried out, and we got the spatial domain decompressed image. So this is one of the example for image transformation. So that is, this example is carried out in communication system. So like this, image transformations will be carried out from one domain to another. Why do we record these transforms? So the main thing is why we are moving from one domain to another domain. That is the thing here we are supposed to say about. That is one, the reason is, first very important reason is, that is fast computation. For this purpose we will be doing some circumstance when we are seeing in spatial domain, some operations are very difficult to carry out, otherwise it is very complex to carry out in spatial domain. at that circumstance we will move to another domain or another form of representation and we will do out the computation. So this is one requirement for transforms. Next, when we are seeing for in-depth analysis of the image, for in-depth analysis of the image, we will be using some transforms. So this tends to move from one domain to another. This is another one important reasons which we are carrying out in image transformation. And finally, to say about the requirement of transformation, that is, this helps to measure, predict and estimate the image coordinates. So that is to the image informations, image coordinate values, pixel values. So all these things for analyzing, for estimating, for measuring, for predicting, all these things, this transform model is highly helpful. So these are the reasons majorly why we require transforms. So regarding this, for the learning of transforms, we can use the normal textbook Digital Image Processing by Gonzalez, as well as we can prefer A.K. Jain, where the transforms are elaborately they have given in a proper order. Thank you.